Today's topic, qualities of sign. Last time, whatever qualities were left, this lecture we are going to cover it. Pay very good attention to this lecture. This is the core of the astrology, which is not written, but it is a very common logic. If you understand this lecture and you apply this lecture, trust me, everything else is on one side. This particular lecture will help you in Vimshottari Dasha. The division of Rashis in Tattva. Fire, earth, water and air. Because see, remember, the planet is a driver. He will drive you to that particular destination for sure. If you're not going to do it on your own before the dasha starts, the planet will say, okay, I will do it. And if it's Rahu, Ketu, Saturn, then you will start crying about the remedies. Then you will say, okay, what is the remedy for it? What is my remedy for this particular Saturn and the Sagittarius, for Rahu and Sagittarius, for Mars and Sagittarius? There's no remedy. The work of Mars is to drive you from point A to point B, and the destination is higher learning. That's it. That is the whole job of a sign to Mars in this particular chart. The second type of Rashis, 4, 8 and 12, Cancer, Scorpio and Pisces, watery signs. These signs are very observant. They feel things, they observe things, and then they react. They never have intuition. They don't have a background knowledge. They are programmable Rashis. See, somebody won a Nobel Prize only because he proved water can be programmed. And if you see Hinduism, all the mantra charana, all the jap, always water goes in the right hand. Because water is programmable. So what the Panditji does, he programs water, then sprinkles on you. To give you a blessing or to give you a curse, the water has to be programmed first. It has to be delivered through water only. So all the three Rashis are programmable. They are just like the blank slate. This is your free will houses. Whatever you will think, fourth house, sign of moon, whatever your emotional fears are, Scorpio, and whatever your free actions are, Pisces. Independent decision making is Pisces. It all depends on you, no, nothing else. You can program it. And what the psychiatrist does? Psychiatrists program these things in a positive manner. It gives you something positive to think. You can overcome your emotional fears over a period of time. Like other day I was reading a book and it said the pain never goes away. The pain always stays there. What happens is with that time the circle grows and you kind of forget about that particular pain. But when in your deep insights during the meditation, when you go inside, you still have that pain. You still can feel it. It always stays there. These are the programmable Rashis. Planet sitting in Cancer. The number one objective of this particular planet is to create peace, is to behave like mother for you, is to make sure you sleep on time, eat on time, and you should have peace in life. You will see in Dasha of Cancer, a person might take extreme steps depending on what combinations he have, extreme steps, only to achieve peace. Just to achieve peace, sometimes people will get division of the houses. So that there should be not much of the tension within the house. People will go through all sorts of things. They will do anything. That planet, objective of that particular planet is to give you peace. If it's Rahu in that sign, Rahu in Cancer, it will adapt a way, adapt very strange ways to achieve peace. Rahu in Cancer, the person will go away from the house, travel long distances, just to achieve peace. So the planet setting in Cancer, number one objective is to make sure that you achieve peace in your life. You should eat on time, sleep on time. That planet is behaving like your mother. Sometimes mother might hit you. Sometimes mother will tell you things which are not good. But she's only doing because she has all the good things at her heart. She wants best things for you. That is why she is doing all the things which you like it, you don't like it. Like when you take your kids to shower, right? The kids will cry in morning. That's their habit. But you know that, you know, they have to take shower every morning. Whether they cry it and they like it, they don't like it, they have to get the haircuts. Nobody likes, none of the kids like it. But this has to be done. You know this. So even when you are crying in the plants in Cancer, they're making sure that you get this done. You achieve peace through it. Their objective is peace. Similarly, the sign of Scorpio, their only objective is transformation. That you should die and born again. Their number one objective, what is the 8th house? 8th house is death. That's what's the number one sign is. That's what the 8th house is known for. That's why nobody likes the sign of Scorpio. Everyone is feared about the 8th house. So if you're feared about the 8th house or the planets sitting in the 8th house, their number one objective is to make sure that your life goes in 180 degrees change. Now if there are benefic planets, they will do it easily for you. If there are malefic planets, they will do this in their own style. But they will definitely do it. That's their objective. A Venus in 8th house sitting in sign of Scorpio, sitting in sign of Capricorn. Okay. Venus in 8th house sitting in sign of Capricorn. Prediction is the person will go through a major change in career due to a woman in this particular age. A woman, because Venus was there, sign of Capricorn is there, it is the 8th house. So the major transformation will happen. Where it will happen? It will happen in the profession. Why it will happen? It will happen because of the lady, because Venus is sitting there. Right? Very simple prediction. Now this guy is a doctor, right? This guy studied medicine in US, did his master's in US. Then a lady came in his life. He met the lady during the program. And after the program, the lady dashed him and he got so mentally disturbed that he could not continue his career after it. A lady came and killed his profession. Transformed him completely. This particular person got psycho when it comes to women now. It means there has to be a curse of women within the chart. Now, this is the one part of the story. Ketu was also aspecting it. In D9 charts, the parental charts, see, when you have to see the parental curses, follow the 9th harmonics of the chart. When you have to follow the maternal curses, follow the 4th harmonics of the chart. 4th harmonics means D4, D40, these are the 4th harmonics charts. D9, D99, and D45, these are the 9th harmonics charts. All throughout the 9th house was afflicted. The sign of parental curses were there. His grandfather, his father, this guy, they all have done sins against the woman. Grandfather used to hit women in the office. Father, same story. This guy, almost same story. So when there is a curse of the Venus in the chart, this particular person is bound to be suffered by Venus. Now, whenever any planet looks at like this combination, if it sublets, suppose it was aspected by Saturn. So you add a flavor to it. You said the woman will be bigger in the age, because Saturn represents old people, right? So Venus is aspected by Saturn. The person will get into the touch of an older woman. If the Mercury also aspects, it's a multiple woman case, because Mercury multiplies. Ketu also aspects it. The woman will have a body deformity, because Ketu represents people who have body deformity. Something is missing. So you see, you add every single detail. These salt and pepper, you have to learn how to add with every small detail what you see. You can predict now Venus in 8,000 sign of Capricorn. Whenever you will see, you will remember this. But let's suppose this particular planet would happen Sagittarius sign, Saturn sitting in there, or any other planet in any other sign would happen there. It can be any combination. I want you to understand what is the basic concept, how I'm using the base of three particular planets, three things: sign, planet, and houses. One prediction. Okay. Planet setting in sign of Scorpio, the work was to make sure that you are reborn. So sign of death is sign of Scorpio. What is the sign of rebirth? What is the sign of rebirth?
Eighth house or Scorpio or both?
Please, if you're writing, please give me with the logic. Why you think it's a sign of rebirth? See, 8,000, you have a death, right? What happens after it? 8,000 is like a Lal Kitab says, 8,000 is like a deep well where nobody knows how deep it is. Aries is a sign where the reborn will happen. Aries is a sign where you can get a rebirth again. That's why 1 to 8, either, see, after the sign of Scorpio, there is a sign of Sagittarius, of higher learning. It is only when you go through this process of death, you get bit of the brain after that. It is only after lot of troubles, you get bit wiser. So either you get a guru who can take you out from this circle of 1 to 8, or either, see, this, there is something called a cycles of the chart. A particular chart operates in a particular cycle. One of the cycles of the chart, which is Aries to Scorpio. Aries to Scorpio is one cycle, and it will keep on repeating after a certain time period. You can see the patterns of the life, and it is not within the chart. It's a generation cycles. Like in, see, throughout the family, same problems will prevail. Throughout the family, same kind of pattern will emerge. To break any kind of life and death cycle, you need a guru. You need the sign of Sagittarius, higher learning. Either you get smart enough to get out of that problem and move towards the higher learning, or you get reborn again in the sign of Aries and you start the same cycle again. These cycles are a bit advanced part, but I'm giving you a hint. This is how the cycle part, when you start using cycles, you will not require dashas, because cycles are used to see the patterns within the life. Patterns of generations are used by cycles. Now, whatever planet is sitting in sign of Pisces, sign of Pisces is for independent decision making, isolation, moksha, higher learning, to give you, to take you to isolation, to a new place, and make sure you get into isolation and learn something new. So whichever planet sits in Pisces, it is bound to do these things for you. So if it is a benefic planet, it will do it in a very easy manner. If it is a malefic planet, it will do it in a very harsh manner. Like if it's a Saturn sitting in Pisces, it will make sure people betray you. People will do things against you in front of you, that you go like, you know, I don't need this world anymore. This world is full of idiots. It will make sure these things happen in front of you. Because what it is trying, what Pisces is trying to give you, the true knowledge of the life. So make sure that you achieve the sign of moksha. See, to achieve moksha, you have to die once at least. You cannot get the moksha while living on the earth. Even when Ravan complained about it, the Narada Muni told him that to achieve moksha, you have to die once. You cannot achieve moksha without dying. So to achieve moksha, you have to be born and reborn again. And after you get reborn again, after several times, you get smarter every time. Every time someone cheats you, you become smarter after that. You become like, okay, next time I will be careful from this thing. But same thing will happen throughout the family. Same pattern will emerge. You will see people will get cheated by same pattern. The family has the same pattern throughout their cycles. They never learn from the mistake because they don't have the guru in their life. Only guru can stop the cycle. Only higher learning can stop the cycle. That is why guru is important. That is why bhagya sign is important in this life. To stop the cycles. People who say, my family had this problem, my grandfather has this problem, and this has a problem, they don't have guru in their whole family eternity. Or they have guru, but they never followed him. They never experienced what is the true work of a guru is. A guru will take you out of the cycle in one go. Sign of if you lost your job in the Ketu position in Sagittarius, it means the Ketu wanted you to learn something new, to grow up. Because Sagittarius, any planet in Sagittarius, what is the objective? His objective is you have taken the train ticket to go to higher learning, and to do higher learning, you're going to lose the job. So whenever you get to the planet which is sitting in the ninth house or in Sagittarius, you join a course before the dasha starts. You sign up for something for the personal development or whatever that planet signification is. You will not lose the job in dasha of Sagittarius. This is how the remedy will work. If the dasha of Cancer is there, that particular planet is making sure you have peace in your life. And to make sure you get the peace, it will go to any limit. That is a job assigned to him. Taking Astro course Jupiter and Tridasha. Okay, but which sign, Krishna? Ninth house, okay. So whichever planets, now the timing should become easy. You should be able to time the event on day-to-day basis based on the prana. And I want you to do it. I want you to predict every single detailed event. See, I don't do consultations anymore. But whenever somebody really urges to me, I pass on the consultation to one of the other guys that you can do it. And he said, you know, sir, I will not do the consultations for your clients anymore. The reason is that your clients are in different level. You predict something which nobody can. And what I did, what was the prediction? I predicted to someone. I sent this guy to him. He said, he predicted to me on this particular date, my father will throw me out of the house. on that particular day, my father did the same. I never used transit. I didn't use anything else. I only used dashas and time. If your birth time is accurate, you can use it. So first thing is rectify the birth time. And before any before any consultation, what we do? We predict events just to see how much is the variation within the events. Whether it is varying by 3 days, 4 days, like other day was doing consultation for someone, and I said, on this particular date, this event happened. And she said, no, 3 days before it happened. So when I know when I'm off by 3 days, it means I have to rectify the time first, then I can only use the chart now. Then I can time the event on that particular date, that particular minute. That after 2 p.m. this event will happen. Like I was timing for one of my friends. I said, on 5th of July, your kid will be born. He called me 10 p.m. in the night and said, you know, the doctor is going back to the back now. There's no labor pain. And 5th of July is already going to get over. What happened? The doctor went off just before, just at 10:30, wife had a labor pain, and by the time doctor could have even come to the hospital, the baby got delivered. So when you have timing event, 5th of July, his son was born. So when you're timing event to the prana dasha, you're very sure about the timing. That this is about to happen. He will never forget in his life that my father kicked me out of the house because this particular person said it. We'll never forget. On 5th of July, my son was born. He thought, because doctor said, we can come tomorrow morning we'll see. But 5th of July, he was born. How are we doing it? We're only using the pranadasha. And I want you to do this. Time events up to pranadasha. Make it a habit. And use all the factors, like I said. Use all your salt, peppers, all the sauce you have, all the soya sauce and all the other fancy sauces you have, Szechuan. Use it and make a prediction. Mix everything. Do not overlook anything. Right? If Jupiter is looking something, that thing is going to be big. The size is big. If Saturn is looking, the thing is old, because that's the quality of Saturn. So you use quality of these planets, quality of the signs, and make a prediction. The sign have directions. You take first house as east, or Aries as east, and then you rotate it east, south, west, north. The head rising and tail rising, the head risings are very straightforward. Okay. They get to the job very quickly. Like Leo is a head, Leo, a king is very straightforward person. He cannot beat the bush. It has to go on. You cannot tell people, you know, you should do this and you should do this. It will come up, come as order. See, have you ever read the notice from the government, right? They are very clear in the instructions. But let's suppose someone has a dasha of Cancer or planet sitting in the Cancer sign. He will go round and round, then come to the topic. So this is the same way the planet sitting in the back rising rashis will do. They're not very clear about the objective. So what they do, they go through the whole city before reaching the destination. When the planet is in the front rising, they're clear about the destination, that this is the way we have to go through. They use Google Maps, and the night rashis, they never use Google Maps. Sony, which house, which if you're running the Rahu Dasha, what is the placement of Rahu? Third house Rahu, Aquarius. So see, third house Rahu. First of all, what is the job assigned to the third house? planets in third house are your natural skill, your hobbies. The first thing Rahu is going to do is, in the long time period, is to make sure you follow your hobbies. That's number one thing. It will make sure you leave your permanent job and do something which is your hobby. Second thing Rahu is going to do is, it is sitting in the house of Aquarius, it is going to generate money for you. So these are the two major tasks assigned to him. Now when this particular task will get linked with some other thing as well, like dash of third lord and tenth lord, or planet sitting in third house and tenth house, when you get this dasha, a major transformation in your career will happen. Especially third, tenth and fifth, when this will make the combination, a major transformation in your career will happen. Now, a very, very wonderful question will arise. Why the event will happen in Rahu, Jupiter, Saturn? Why not in Rahu, Saturn, Jupiter? Right? As a student of astrology, you should always think logically that why in this particular time period only the event will happen? Because the sequence is same, right? Rahu, Saturn, Jupiter. Rahu, Jupiter, Saturn. It can go either way. But in which particular dasha the event will happen? It depends on the strength of the chart, the strength of the planet, whether it is able to give the results or not. For these things, use Bhavabal, Shadbal and Avasthas of planet. So you will get very clear that which particular planet will give the result and which particular planet is not going to give the result.
Sir, I have a question. We talked about the Mahadasha, Antardasha and then Pratyantardasha and the strength of the planets in that and deciding which will be more effective. Yes, so how do we decide? Means the strength should be more in Mahadasha or it should be more in Antardasha or Pratyantardasha?
Okay, let's suppose you are in the dasha of Rahu, Jupiter, Saturn. Okay. And you want to see whether the event will happen in Jupiter, Saturn or Saturn, Jupiter. Right? This is what we have to decide. So let's suppose a Mahadasha, the Antardasha, the Jupiter is not allowing the event to happen. Jupiter does not have that capability to give a rise to that particular big event. Right? So we will say that Jupiter Dasha, this event will not happen. But if this Jupiter will come in the Pratyanta Dasha or in the Sukshma Dasha, it can support the event. Like, let's suppose there are three people who have to lift something up. You cannot put the person with the least amount of power as a in charge in the front. You will tell him, okay, just hold it in the side. Just support it when we will lift it up. This is way the Mahadasha, Antardasha and Pratyantardasha works. So whenever a big work has to be done, it has to be the Antardasha Lord. Mahadasha Lord should not oppose it at least. Antardasha should be the main factor for that particular event. It should be very powerful. The Pratyantardasha Lord should be also powerful, but it should also support it. Okay. Then the Sukshma Dasha, Prana Dasha, when you get the supporting time periods, the event will happen.